This episode was brought to you by Skillshare.
Hey everyone, today I'm joined by Virginia Schutte, whom you may remember from a past video that we recorded together on animal navigation through the open ocean. And we had such a lovely time doing that the last time that we thought it was time to do it again with a new video.
There is a simple reason that Shark Week is so popular and planet Earth sometimes feels like a list of predatory encounters. Animals eating other animals is fascinating. Every time a carnivore eats, it's a full story with characters, a conflict, and a resolution. And as such, we are giving you today our top 5 most inventive ways that animals hunt together in the ocean.
Animals will only hunt if they gain more than they lose when capturing, killing, and eating their prey. The details of the hunt become important in determining which way the scale tips. Is it going to be a long chase or a short one? Is it possible that the hunter could get injured during the hunt? The expected cost must be less than the expected benefits for a hunting animal to choose to go after a particular piece of prey.
These hunt details are where there's room for cooperative hunting to emerge as a good strategy. Sometimes everybody gets more food by working together. The equation stays the same. Is the gain for an individual worth the cost of hunting with other individuals? And things get really interesting when you add in cheaters and scavengers who will sometimes or even always let others do the work and then try to take some of the kill anyway.
Cooperative hunting is not rare in the ocean, and this is because the ocean is a big place and cooperation offers predators a chance to concentrate prey in denser patches or otherwise reach prey that they wouldn't be able to without working together. Hunting in groups also confuses prey. For example, sailfish either swipe left or right with their heads as they snap up prey fish. An individual sailfish always either swipes left or right, but hunting sailfish form groups with almost exactly the same number of left and right swiping predators. So this means that the prey never actually knows where the next attack might come from.
Everything from squid to whales work together to corral, trap, and otherwise corner their prey so that they can eat. We're going to focus here on some of the more unique examples of cooperative hunting in the ocean. So, let's start off with orcas. Orcas wave wash seals off of small icebergs in Antarctica. The whales line up side by side with their backs just under the surface of the water. Then they swim together towards the iceberg, diving down right before they ram into the ice. The wave created by their swimming continues onto the iceberg, slamming into the seal and sometimes knocking it into the ocean. And if wave washing doesn't work, the orcas work together to tip the iceberg over and they dump the seal into the ocean anyway.
Next up, we've got the dolphins. The classic examples of dolphins hunting together is that one dolphin drives fish towards a dolphin barrier, causing the fish to leap into the air to escape, only to be eaten by the dolphins at the water's surface. But dolphins are very social and extremely intelligent, so they also have more specialized hunting techniques. Dolphins on the southeastern coast of the US spread out to corral fish towards a beach. Using sound cues underwater, they signal one another and then all rush the fish at the same time, crashing ashore in a heap. The fish flop ashore ahead of them and then literally jump into the dolphins' waiting jaws.
We're still not done with dolphins yet though. Other dolphins in Florida hunt in shallow, muddy waters. They swim along the bottom, kicking up mud clouds with their tails as they go, muddying the water in a large circle. Then they spiral inward slowly to tighten the circle until their prey fish are bunched in the middle of their mud net. Then they literally lie back on the water surface and wait for the fish to jump into their mouths. Humpback whales also make their own nets, but in their case, the nets are made of bubbles, and the whales are chasing very small critters like krill and plankton, which they engulf with their huge mouths once these critters are concentrated inside the bubble net.
However, hunting parties aren't always made of the same species. Large fish on coral reefs are speed-eating machines in open water, but have trouble flushing smaller fish out of hiding places in the reef. So in the Red Sea, these fish do the fish equivalent of a human pointing. A headstand paired with a headshake lets eels or octopus know that there's hidden prey right where they're pointing. The flexible eels and octopus can either scare the smaller fish out for the larger fish to eat, or they might snag it for themselves. And similar associations occur in the opposite direction between predator fish that scare prey fish into the nooks and crannies of the reef, where they're eaten by slowpoke sea snakes that can wriggle into the hiding spot.
And last but definitely not least are some examples that involve humans. There are 2 examples of wild, untrained marine animals voluntarily cooperating with humans to hunt. The first is a variation of the beaching strategy that dolphins use that we talked about earlier. In Brazil, dolphins drive fish toward fishermen waiting in the water, who then cast their nets in the ball of fish. The dolphins presumably benefit from the chaos, snapping up fish that scatter once the net is thrown. The second example involving humans was with orcas. In the 1860s in Australia, a pod of orcas would drive larger whales into a bay and trap them there. Then the pod leader would swim up to a whaling station and slap his tail on the surface of the water to signal that there were whales in the bay. After capturing and killing the whales, the whalers would hang the carcasses in the water so that the orcas could eat the tasty bit of the whales' heads, leaving the valuable parts which the whalers would then harvest later. Once the pod leader died, the cooperative orca pod completely disappeared.
And these were our top five most unique examples of cooperative hunting in the ocean. Proof that corporate team building exercises could be a whole lot more interesting.
Speaking of which, if you would like to learn cooperatively, perhaps not hunting in the ocean, but other productive skills such as video production, animation, programming and more, then why not sign up for Skillshare? I've been using them for over a year to learn and develop my own skills, and they are currently offering 2 free months to any curious subscriber who would like to try them out over at skl.sh/drawcuriosity2.
We really hope you enjoyed today's episode. We had a lot of fun making it. Thank you so much to Virginia for coming up with such an original idea. And as always, you can find out all about her work over on her website, Real Life Science. And as always, thank you for watching us, and I'll see you in the next one.